What's going on, everybody? Fallen Foe back again, and today we are going to finally be talking about my desk. I get asked on the daily, if not hourly, what my desk is, what parts are on it, and how they built it. So let's jump in and I will show you guys everything about it, where I got it from, and how much it cost. So if you aren't familiar yet, this is what my desk looks like. It is a giant L-shaped desk that is nudged in the corner of my room. And it actually utilizes two different tabletops as well as these drawers, but I will get into the names and where I got it in a second. If you are not already, make sure to smash that subscribe button and like this video because you are not gonna wanna miss these upcoming videos. Okay, really? And we are out here on the YouTube grind. We are pushing to go full-time YouTube soon. So every subscription helps more than you know. And if you like tech, this is your place. So everything you see here in my desk is all from IKEA. And if you don't know what IKEA is, I feel bad for you. And or the people that don't have one close, my local IKEA is probably like 10 minutes from here. So I'm there probably every weekend. They've probably got me on a first name basis at this point. So this desk hack was actually figured out by using countertops. These tops were originally not made for desks. IKEA released these to put on top of countertops in people's kitchens, and people eventually found out that, hey, I could put this on top of my stands and turn it into a desk. This video is not sponsored by IKEA. I just genuinely like their products because it's cheap and it's good quality. But I mean, IKEA, hey, if you want to throw your boy a message, we can work together. So I'm on IKEA's website right now. So what these desktops used to be called was the Linman, but now they have changed it to the Lag Captain. Whatever this is right here, Lag Captain, that's what it's called. I think I'm saying it right.
And as for this main desk, if you can tell, let me grab a keyboard for size comparison. If you can tell how shallow this one is, it's only about 24 inches deep.
That's what she said.
And the keyboard goes more than halfway up. Now, as you can tell on my primary desk, it doesn't even go half. I made sure to use the countertop that was a lot deeper for where I'm primary sitting at, because if not, my monitors would come out to about right here and it would leave me with a tiny bit of room. So I went with the nice deep countertop for where I'm sitting at, and then the side ones, being I'm not really sitting here that much, is a little bit narrower, but a lot longer. So both of these are Lag Captains. This one right here that ends right on the edge of this mouse pad where that line is the 47 inch variant. And then this super long one that runs all the way to the wall, all the way to this edge, is the 78 inch variant. And this desktop was $47. And this main desktop right here was only $23. Now these two side drawers are optional, but I highly recommend both of these. Before I had both of these, I was just using these legs on each side, which doesn't look too bad. It looks kind of naked in my opinion, but it is amazing for storage. I mean, I have all of my drawers stacked with different things. I have a camera drawer down here. I've got lighting in this drawer. This is kind of my junk drawer catch-all with scissors, screwdrivers, fan controllers, RGB controllers. I've got keyboard stuff in this one. I highly recommend budgeting at least for one, if not two, Alex drawers. And those come in at $79 a piece, which is a little steep, but you could always build the desk with just the legs on each side and then save up and spend the $140 and get the Alex drawers down the road like I did. And then last but not least, we have the Adil's legs. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4 legs holding up my desk, which realistically this leg right here doesn't need to be there, but it just supports this corner, being that it's kind of free floating. But you're definitely gonna want one on this long desk in the middle, one in the corner, and then one kind of supporting where the backside of the two tabletops connect. Now these are only $4 a piece and they have a bunch of different colors. And I actually have a couple extra ones stuffed in my closet just because they were cheap enough, it was worth it. Bringing our entire total for this whole desk to $245. Now wait.
Just wait 1 minute. I know it sounds like a lot of money, but think about it.
Look how big this desk is. I have a triple monitor set up over here. Speakers, mouse pad, all my peripherals, and still, I have all this room over here. This whole corner is unutilized, well, kind of, but I don't know what to do with it, but full pegboard, full desk pad, PC all the way in the corner, and I still have extra room. Now you can get a little bit more expensive options. They do have countertops that look like a piece of granite or marble that are solid wood. And I will say about this countertop, it does start to show its wear. I've had this probably a year, and the most wear I've had is these little chip marks right here. But with those little chip marks, I just take a color pen and just paint it over white, and you can't really tell. but it is like a hollow kind of cardboard-ish material, so if you jump on it or sit on it, it's probably gonna break. You also want to be very careful if you're mounting like a very large monitor arm on here, because if you clamp too hard, it will crack the desk. So this is really best used if you have a wall-mounted monitor setup, or you only have like one or two monitors that are clamped onto a piece of wood that's clamped on underneath the desk. Other than that, that's my full desk setup, and I'm telling you, you cannot find a better desk for under $300 than this one right here.
Hopefully my quick little spiel helped some of you guys decide if you were looking at getting one of these desks, or if you were going to upgrade one of your desks and get some Alex drawers, or add on another tabletop to your currently existing desk to make it a full L-shaped desk. I hope I was able to persuade you.
And one last final thing before I forget, I get asked a ton on how I connected both of my desktops together. All I did was I took a little piece of metal and screwed it on both sides of the desk where it connects.
And it's held it together for the past year. It hasn't fallen apart, so I guess it works. Thank you guys so much for watching today's video. Make sure to smash that subscribe button, hit that like, and drop a comment down below and let me know what kind of desk you use. And should I upgrade my Linman tabletops that are cardboard to something super nice that's like a solid piece of wood that's a little bit lighter color, like a wood grain? Let me know with a comment down below. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next video.